Well, this weather wasn't expected. It is pretty foggy out, and that's not exactly the weather you want when you're, shooting a Ride With Me video. However, let me promise you, we're going to be going up 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 feet in elevation, and we break out of this fog pretty quick. So why don't we hop on the bike, and as we're riding up, I'll explain exactly the route that we're taking today on this ride through the San Bernardino National Forest. Our plan today is to ride 30 miles through a mix of paved and forest roads that wind through the San Bernardino National Forest. First, we'll follow Route 38 all the way up past the blink and you'll miss it town of Angeles Oaks, California. From there, we'll turn left on Cedar Falls Road before jumping on a maze of dirt roads that promise to take us along the ridge of the mountains before dropping us into the popular skiing town of Big Bear. Turning onto Cedar Falls Road, and it looks like the fog isn't going to be the only problem we face today. Turns out, this road is private. After a quick glance at Google Maps, I'm going to switch up our route and take a forest road a little further up Route 38. From there, we should be able to reconnect with the initial plan. Normally the ride up that paved road would be visually spectacular. Not only do you have all the twists and turns, but to the left you have a gorgeous view of the valley breaking out every now and then, but then as you go back in you're going through the woods and it's just gorgeous normally, but today is foggy. But now I'm on new territory, I'm on a forest road, and hopefully I won't get in over my skis because, well, what happens when I get in over my skis? Something like that, and I end up having to glue the bike back together. So today's plan is, if it gets anywhere remotely close to the edge of my skill level, turn around, making it back to the main road and taking one of the alternate routes to Big Bear Lake. Have a what's called a bash plate. It's supposed to protect the exhaust in the front of the bike and underneath of the bike from rocks and such. However, two of the brackets, the two screws underneath, came all the way out, and so now it's literally just dangling. So I think I'm gonna have to take it off and ride unprotected the rest of the way, because I don't have any screws that size to put it back up. Great. So this ride has not gone as planned. To say I'm not frustrated would be a lie. I'm actually quite frustrated. So I'm getting up to the section where I'm pretty sure if I was able to keep going, I'd be able to break out of this fog and get some possibly really epic views of the valley with fog laying down. But the road is closed. So, I mean, it's obvious there's some dirt bikes and such that have gone up and around, but A, road's closed, so I'm not going, but B, it's closed because hasn't been open since the winter, so there could be some washouts and stuff from the melting snow. So I'm going to take this road back. There is a road that goes to the left, but it loops around, and it is already 5:49, so I'm not sure if I'd have enough time to complete that big loop, and if I ran into another closed road further down, I'd be in trouble. So I think my plan is make it back to the paved road and then see where that paved road ends up. See if it ends up over toward Big Bear or if it just connects back to the main road near our campsite, which if that's the case, I'll probably just turn in, make it the rest of the way to our campsite, and call our campsite the end of the road for today. So funny to me, spent the entire day not quite breaking through that fog, but still coming over here, getting back up out of the fog just a few miles before the campsite. Just reminds me, in all the frustration I was having with my trails being closed, really it's just getting out and enjoying God's creation that I like the most, and just kind of reset, coming back out in the sunshine and seeing what I came out of. Well, the plan for this video was to have a cool little route that you could do from Riverside or just outside Riverside all the way over the mountains and to Big Bear Lake. That plan did not work out, but that's part of the adventure, isn't it? Stuff happens, you get through it, you figure it out, and you have a good time. Most of the time. Sometimes you get a little frustrated, but it happens. Anyway, hopefully next time we'll see you on the open road. Bye. That's Kaylin's part. She's not here, so I figured I'd do it instead.